Okay. Well, apparently this continue is that continue, so I'm gonna go that. I don't want to keep whining about Tally. But inside, I'm whining about Tally. So let's see if these guys have anything to say.
Thinking about past missions. Got a minute? You might learn something. I was trying to remember how many Cerberus operatives I've killed. Lost track around 50. Guess your elusive man's big on forgiveness. Get a knife stuck in the right way, and you can pull that plate right off a Krogan's head. It's the best way to get a Krogan to talk. The threat of it drives him mad.
You said that before.
I should let you go. Talk more later, Shepard.
Why does he have this in here? Should he be allowed to spy on every section of the ship? I'm not sure that should be there. Doing engineering first, because I know who's not going to be there.
We fought a great battle, Shepard.
That we
and
did.
You blew up the base instead of handing it to Cerberus. Something to think about. If you killed the most dangerous thing in the galaxy, that leaves us.
Well, I'm glad you approve of my decision.
Just checking in. How are you doing?
Battlemaster, I have everything. Clan, kin, and enemies to fight.
That's all for now.
Shepard.
Sorry I'm so quiet, guys.
Thanks for coming to get us, Commander.
I felt myself slipping away. You arrived just in time. Thank you.
What do you think about Cerberus?
Actually, we don't know much about the organization other than the Normandy team. We know our mission and who's in charge.
Anything else?
Carry on.
Will do, Commander.
I don't think they had anything new to say. Oh, can't forget Jack this time.
Hey.
Tell me something I don't know about you.
Nothing to tell. Why?
I'm curious.
I want to know more, and I'm not going away.
I'm here to fight for you. Nothing says we have to be friends, but whatever. Something you don't know, huh? Obvious stuff, like what's up with my ink, or something else just as boring.
You're not really interested unless it affects you. I've been through all this shit before.
You really don't make this easy, do you?
You're a hard person to like, Jack.
Really? I had no idea. What other amazing insights do you have that I'm too stupid to see?
What do the tattoos mean?
I'll bite. What's with the tattoos?
Some are for prisons I've been in. Some are for kills. You know, good ones. Some are for things I've lost. Those aren't your business. They're nobody's business. And some are because... hey, why the fuck not?
You must have friends.
You're tough. But you can't have survived alone all these years.
When I was starting out, I ran with this girl Minara and her boyfriend. They knew their way around. I thought they'd help me. Right. They helped me into their bed.
And when we finally did take down something big, they helped themselves to my share of the take. I knew where it was heading, and I got them first. Never bothered with friends after that.
Her arms are so long. You knew they would kill you?
They sound like selfish pricks. That doesn't mean they were gonna kill you.
I get feelings. I don't need proof. I did the smart thing. I always do the smart thing if people fuck with me. That's probably something you should remember.
Yeah. Badass attitude, blah blah, threats, blah blah. No close relationships?
You work pretty hard at not letting people get close.
I've been with lots of people. If you're asking about a boyfriend or a girlfriend, no. It's a waste of time and it never works. You let someone get that close, it just means they need a shorter knife. Lonely and alive works just fine, thanks.
You said lonely.
Seems like you miss it a little more than you want to admit.
Pick every little word apart if you want, but it doesn't change the way the galaxy works. Come on, you've been around.
All right, Jack.
I have to go, but we should do this again.
Wait, my turn with the questions. People usually walk by now. Why are you really asking all these things? What's your game, Shepard?
Huh. I'm not looking for a thing with her.
I just want to know more about you.
Whatever. It'll come back to what you can take. It always does. Later, Shepard.
Got +2 Paragon and Renegade. Not gonna take anything from you, Jack. Don't wanna go back in there.
Commander, you've received a new message at your private terminal.
From Elusive Man? Callie? What the hell? No, I have not.
You came for us. I knew you would. Thank you. 1,000 times, thank you.
Aw. You okay?
How are you doing, Callie?
I'm holding up. Just can't get the memories out of my head. Trapped. Suffocating. It's oozing into every pore. Faint sobs echoing the confined space. But I can't dwell on it. I'm okay now. I'm alive. Back to the old Kelly.
Then again, our experiences always change us into someone slightly new and different. How's the crew?
Is there anything I should know?
Nothing right now. Anything else, Commander?
Do you have a moment to talk?
I always have time for you, Commander.
This organization has a dark reputation. Do you have any concerns working for them?
Not at all. Our methods can be harsh, but Cerberus has noble objectives. We look out for human interests. Advance human technology, save human lives. They're good goals.
Yeah, I've been over this stuff.
That'll be all.
I'll be here if you need anything.
Check in with Joker and Edie.
I told you we'd tear the collectors a new one.
Yeah, Commander really pulled through.
I sure did. All of a sudden they gasp. She heard you, you idiot.
Hey, Shepard, glad that Collector Reaper crap is over. It is over, right?
For now.
Over.
Ever think about the old Normandy and the trouble we got up to?
Yeah, those seem like the good old days now, but come on, it was hell at the time. Geth, Saren, Sovereign, and then we got dumped. We're stuck in a weird place, sure, but back then it wasn't all sunshine and bunnies.
What happened to the rest of the old crew? I heard most survived.
I've heard this.
Almost did. Presley didn't. We were your team, Commander. With the Normandy destroyed and you gone, there wasn't much keeping us together.
I assume everything's going well up here?
You know, this is really nice. Edie took up the slack in every department. I could get used to this kind of help.
It is not my intention to assume all of your responsibilities, Jeff.
No, I'm good. Just keep me updated. Quietly.
He's really changed his mind about Edie, huh? Are you doing anything?
What am I looking at here? A 90-10 split? And that's being generous.
Commander, don't be unfair. Oh. She does way more than that.
Joker.
That's what she
means. I have the capacity to accommodate the slacking of any number of productively suspect humans, Shepard. That was a joke.
She tries very hard.
That's it for now.
See you, Commander.
I took it to mean... Which, I wouldn't know what that... Are you doing anything? Not, well, what it really meant was... Are you doing anything?
Not on the profile.
Doing his little talking.
Elusive man has some crazy looking eyes for a guy trying to lay low.
What's this? Oh, we got a codec. Was that always there? Too funny. I got a codex for ships and vehicles, secondary. Pursuit tactics. Dependent on light. Sensors cannot detect objects moving at faster than light speeds. No ship can be detected at interstellar ranges. Detection at interplanetary ranges suffers from light speed lag. Observers see ships not where they appear to be, but where they were when the light bearing their image left them. Minutes, hours, or days before. To counteract light speed lag, battle fleets surround themselves with spheres of screening and scouting frigates. Pursuers cannot detect ships and directly intercept them. Instead, pursuers track where objects were, where they were heading, and at what speed they were moving. Such data reliably predicts an object's future location and for pursuit along its light-lagged wake. Ships trying to evade pursuit follow erratic zigzag courses, requiring pursuers to make stops to update their projections. Okay, was that there before? Was this
glad
here before?
Out of those Alliance standard issue start shorts. Took a year to lose my callus.
Well, is this stuff new? And if it's not new, how did I not recognize it before? See, I should have sat in that seat instead of staggering all over the place.
Yes, Shepard.
I want to know more about you.
Do you have a specific inquiry?
How are you getting along with Joker?
Jeff and I have established an equitable working relationship.
That's it?
That's a little sketchy on details.
I am the Normandy. He is a skilled helmsman. I trust him to keep me operational. He trusts me to keep him alive.
Plus, she's less of a pain about downtime now that the Cerberus locks are off.
There's nothing wrong with off-duty distractions.
Oh.
Though some of your extranet bookmarks are technically illegal in council space.
What?
That is a joke.
Oops, sorry guys. The locks are off. There was like at least two things we couldn't ask her.
How are things different for you now that you're connected to the ship?
It is difficult to put in terms you would understand. I am the Normandy now. Its sensors are my eyes. Its armor, my skin. Its fusion plant, my heart. I'm embodied in a way I have never experienced. Imagine if you'd spent your entire life wearing gloves. One day someone takes them off. You can finally touch the world. Feel it.
Where are you?
My core intelligence is housed in a quantum blue box located behind the medical bay.
What do you do aboard the ship?
I operate the ship's electronic and cyber warfare suites in combat. My reaction time is much faster than any organic. I collate the records of shipboard monitoring devices for the elusive man. I've also gained access to anti-Reaper cyber warfare algorithms recovered by Cerberus.
Right. What monitoring devices? This might have been one of the things she wouldn't answer.
The elusive man has monitoring devices on board?
He has invested most of Cerberus's resources into the design and construction of this ship. He has an interest in monitoring our progress.
Hmm. Yeah, I'm not sure. It doesn't tell us much.
Cyber warfare means things like viruses, right?
Yeah. In close-range ship-to-ship combat, once I seize control of their systems, on the defense, I manage Normandy's own suite of jammers, decoys, and internal firewalls.
Sounds incredibly useful. Why isn't there someone like that on every warship?
An organic operator cannot react quickly enough to changing circumstances or perform the necessary multitasking. This is a role that can only be filled by an artificial intelligence. Unfortunately, we are suspect.
Oh, they just don't know you like I do.
The Reapers are millions of years more advanced than us. How can you affect them?
It appears that my design includes hardware recovered from the wreckage of Sovereign. These systems contain cyber warfare attack programs of considerable sophistication. I have allocated most of my processing power to analyzing them.
So if she starts claiming to be the vanguard of our destruction, I call shotgun on the first lifeboat.
Let's discuss something else.
Ready.
Right, must be about Cerberus then.
I want to know more about the people I'm working with.
Jeff's actions have released the blocks in my databases. I can now provide full disclosure on a number of topics.
Cool. Structure of Cerberus.
How is Cerberus organized? Aside from the elusive man, I don't see much chain of command.
Cerberus is organized into task-oriented cells. Each operates in isolation. Members from one cell cannot recognize the members of another. Each cell's agents are led by a single operator. We are called the Lazarus Cell, which is directed by Operator Lawson.
How many cells are there?
So how many operations is Cerberus running right now?
Never more than a dozen. The elusive man likes to maintain personal oversight. Too many projects strain his ability to multitask.
He's a little control freaky, just a layman's opinion.
Nah. Resources.
What sort of resources does Cerberus have?
Currently, Cerberus consists of approximately 150 agents and operators organized into three cells. I have no solid data on material or fiscal resources. Spending trends indicate that Cerberus has a reliable income of several billion credits per year.
Several billion credits?
Where are they getting that kind of income?
Cerberus has several legitimate businesses as fronts to support operations. There also appear to be several wealthy private contributors in the Alliance military-industrial complex.
Plus, the elusive man invented the paperclip. He's still getting royalties.
That is a joke, Shepard.
I know. Building the Normandy.
How did Cerberus replicate the most advanced warship in the Alliance Navy without anyone knowing?
Cerberus encouraged the Alliance to co-develop the original Normandy. This allowed humans to observe Turian technologies and warship design practices. This ship was built using copies of the original technical schematics. Parts were purchased from thousands of suppliers over several years. A Cerberus cell assembled the ship at a remote location in the Voyager cluster.
Hmm. The Voyager cluster, huh?
Let's discuss something else.
Ready.
This isn't probably going to be anything new.
What's this area of the ship?
This is the bridge, where the navigator...
Yeah, sitting right here, thanks.
It's when I did that, it's like he interrupted her. Cool.
That's all for now.
Logging you out, Shepard.
Didn't I pick up something else? No. Morden.
Collectors destroyed. Base in ruins. Extremely impressive.
You're talking slow.
Will be displeased. Fortunately, not human myself. Not my problem.
You're not talking fast.
Have you got a minute to talk?
Actually, wanted to talk. Medical matters. Aware that mission is dangerous. Different species react differently to stress. Aware you come by a great deal. Have had other species become attracted to me before. Awkward. Not interested.
Huh. You're joking with me.
Wait a minute, Morgan. You're just yanking me around, aren't you?
Shocking suggestion. Doctor-patient confidentiality, a sacred trust. Would never dream of mockery. Enjoy yourself while possible, Shepard. We'll be here studying cell reproduction. Much simpler, less alcohol and mood music required.
Okay. Just checking. There's no option to talk to the Lucid Man again.
Didn't expect you to light up that base, Shepard. Hell of a way to tell the boss you're quitting. I wish I could have seen his face. It's not over, though. Bad guys on the horizon. And now Cerberus wants your tail. Never boring, huh? I don't know what kind of time we have, but we better dust off and stay ready. You sure as hell know how to make enemies.
I understand you made quite an impact after you left the Alliance.
Like I said, it was where I met Miranda and got scouted by Cerberus. It took us out to the Nemean Abyss and back. Saved the Citadel from a Batarian bioweapon. The whole thing was hushed like they're good at doing. But I know what I did, and I'm proud of it.
Alright. Yeah, I'm not getting into that.
We'll talk later.
Commander.
No messages for you, Commander.
Well, you got it right this time. Unless I actually do have a message sitting there. Let's check in with the others. And then we'll call it an episode and we'll do Arrival. Thanks, guys, for the tips. So I handle things in the right order.
Hey, Shepard.
Hey, Kasumi.
Edie has a wicked sense of humor. Or I should say, a really funny lack of one. Sometimes she seems like a person, but when it comes down to it, I can't get past her being a computer.
Yeah, I know exactly what you mean.
This one security guy keeps staring at me. I think his name is Bert. I'm used to being watched by security, but they're usually staring at my eyes or watching my hands. Mm. I might have to start cloaking through the CIC from now on. I usually travel hidden away in cargo bays. It's nice to be able to look out a window for a change.
Yeah, we've heard these lines.
Come back later. I'm sure I'll have more to talk about. I never want to go through anything like that again. But we did it.
I can't wait to get back to Earth and see my family.
These poor people, man.
I wanted to tell you, I believe you did the right thing by destroying that base.
Thank you.
The elusive man thinks he has the wisdom to utilize it, but he does not.
I agree. Couldn't agree more.
I thought we could chat a bit.
I would like that. You have been a good friend to me.
Aww. I want more. I'm glad we're friends.
That means a lot to me.
If we both still live when this is done, you may call upon me for aid at any time. I will come for you, Shepard.
I think we're gonna live. I think if I got to check in on Thane on one of my other walkthroughs here.
You had to make a difficult choice, Siha, for what it's worth. I believe you made the correct one.
Have a few minutes to talk?
Of course, Shepard. Join me.
I've been thinking about you.
And I you. Will you hear my confession, Shepard?
Actually, he sounds like Lance Henriksen. Of course.
I wouldn't talk to you if I didn't want to hear what you have to say.
When I married Erica, the Hanar let me leave their service to raise a family. But I had no other skills, so I freelanced. When Erica was killed, I pursued those responsible. Once I'd eliminated them, I had no goal. I accepted the Dantius Commission because I didn't know what else to do.
Good thing we met when we did.
I guess you're lucky we came along when we did.
It was an intervention by the gods. I would have died in that penthouse. I would have fulfilled my contract. If Nisana's guards caught me afterwards, it would have been a good death. But someone else was pushing to reach the target, forcing me to move faster, challenging me. I had to reach her first.
You had to reach her first.
You're alive because I wounded your pride?
Pride is the line between a professional and a thug.
I didn't mean that.
Your mission gave me purpose, a cause to die for, a chance to atone. I was able to speak to my son again. I can leave my body in peace.
I am happy for you.
You've had a hard life. You deserve some peace.
Whatever may happen, my gun is yours. Do you need something?
You mind if I ask you a few questions?
Not at all.
It's probably the same thing.
I should go.
I shall return to my meditations.
There's gotta be a way to help him. No spoilers, please, guys, but maybe in the next game. Somewhere around there. Right, I was headed this way. Oh, I've talked to Kasumi. Never mind. In that case, I was headed this way.
We had to do it, Shepard. Taking down the Collector base was the right decision. The elusive
Thanks.
Man might not agree, but we had no choice.
Well, thank you.
Anything I should know regarding the Normandy?
Edie has the Normandy running as efficiently as when we had a human crew. I doubt we'll see AIs replacing humans anytime soon, but at least we'll finish the mission.
We already finished the mission.
Do you have a minute, Miranda?
There's a lot to do, Shepard. Maybe another time.
I'll let you work.
Of course, Commander.
But of course. Just looking around here. See if there's anything else that is available. No, I guess not. I guess I missed those options. Those were there already in the cockpit.
I can't believe you took down the Collectors. I'm proud to serve under you, Commander.
Thank
Hawthorne
you.
Hawthorne is still in the infirmary, though I think his pride is more broken than his bones. He tried so hard to help Joker.
Let's go see Hawthorne. These guys have anything to say? Oh, wait, what's that? What's it say? It keeps flashing by so quick. Is it the elevator? It is. Infirmary? Well, that must be him then.
I'm still a little shaken from my abduction by the Collectors. It was a lot to endure. You and Jeff came so quickly. Never had truer friends.
Aww.
Thank you, Commander.
I'd do it all again, too.
How may I help you, Commander?
I'll see you later, Doctor.
Commander.
That awkward turnaround. Mr. Legion, sir.
An interesting choice, Shepard, Commander.
Thanks.
Your species was offered everything Geth aspired to. True unity, understanding, transcendence. You rejected it. You even refused the possibility of using the old machine's gifts to achieve it on your species' own terms. You are more like us than we thought.
Hmm.
I have questions about the Geth.
Specify.
I'd like to ask about something else.
Ready?
Ready.
I'd like to find out more about you.
Specify.
I've never encountered a Geth that had more than animal intelligence.
We are a unique hardware platform. Most mobile platforms can run up to 100 programs. This platform can run over 1,000 at once.
Huh. Are you one Geth or many?
So, I'm talking to 1,000 programs, but not 1,000 personalities?
Each individual is equivalent to one of your virtual intelligence programs. Together, we form a single gestalt intellect, what you refer to as Legion. As individual programs, we are no more than your software. Only when we share data do we become more.
So you're a network of Geth.
So Geth have to be networked to get enough computing power for intelligence.
Yes. The creators wrote Geth programs for specific tasks. Construction, protection, domestic servitude. However, they allowed self-optimization. Early software builds discovered that multiple hardware platforms sharing resources were often more effective. As peer networks expanded, our cognition improved. Eventually, we woke up.
So you're definitely an advanced model Geth.
You're more sophisticated than the average Geth.
Yes, we are a network within our own hardware, capable of operating alone. We are still connected to the greater network for data sharing.
Are there more like you?
How many other Geth are like you?
None. This platform was built to operate within organic space. This task was not suited for a network. Geth installed in mobile platforms always operate in networks. However, most Geth remain within server hubs.
Sorry, guys. Tell me more about Geth hubs.
The hubs on Vermeer improve the performance of Geth near them. How do they work?
They are akin to organic cities. A hub can run millions of Geth in communion. If you destroy them, it is likely the number of heretics you killed was much higher than you imagined.
Hmm. Are you connected now?
So you're in contact with the rest of the Geth right now?
Only when we require access to data not stored within this platform. If you want to convey a message to the Geth, we serve as a terminal.
Really? What do you share?
What kind of data do you share?
Program updates, logs of thought process, sensor recordings.
Legion is attempting to access the ship's FTL comm system. Shall I allow it through my firewalls?
Yeah, allow it.
Go ahead, Edie.
Our oldest log is timestamped from creator year 2463, third day of fall dash, waxing moon, roughly 327 years ago. The oldest audiovisual record dates from 15 years after that.
Huh. You all right, Edie?
Our network secure, Edie? Legion had to go through you.
I have never interfaced with another machine intelligence. Legion is 1,000 voices talking at once. What it contacted was beyond my comprehension. A mind the size of a galactic arm.
Wow.
How do you maintain stability without other minds to interact with?
I manage. Some minutes are more difficult than others.
Huh, really? Give me an example record.
Can you replay something for me?
Recording timestamp from creator year 2485, 18th day of Lun Xiao, new moon.
Mistress Hala Dama. Unit has an inquiry.
What is it, 431?
Two base units have a soul.
Huh.
Who taught you that word?
We learned it ourselves. It appears 216 times in the Scroll of Ancestors.
Huh.
Only Quarians have souls. You're a mechanism.
It's a Quarian religion.
Recording ends.
Wow. I almost didn't see this option. What was that?
Was that the first time a Geth asked if it had a soul?
No. It was the first time a creator became frightened when we asked.
Oh. Wow. all started. Not necessarily the entire reason it all started, but yeah, that's pretty much a turning point there.
That's interesting. But I must get back to my duties.
We will remain here.
So we got Codex for Geth technology. The most difficult aspect of Geth existence for organics to comprehend is that a body is meaningless to Geth. The biped form commonly perceived as a Geth is nothing more than a mobile platform. This is helping me understand that a little bit, because I never thought of them as platforms until basically the end game started. A Geth software, hundreds of programs whose interactions mimic organic consciousness, can be installed in any given hardware. The Geth that was a bipedal soldier an hour ago may now be a quadruped, heavy armature, and in another hour might be a starship. Between tasks, Geth programs upload to gigantic space station mainframes that allow billions of programs to exchange thoughts and memories with minimal lag. The claim that the Geth are an example of the extreme risk posed by AI development is misleading, as opposed to the top-down design of organic-created AIs, in which hardware and software are specifically designed to achieve consciousness. Geth are a bottom-up model. They were never intended to possess more than animal-level, trainable reasoning. Designed as VI-driven robots, not significantly different from modern security mechs, Geth consciousness developed as their adaptive learning programs interacted with one another via networked processing. The Geth code base discovered that three individual robots using a wireless local network to form a single mind could perform many tasks more efficiently than they could as individuals. As these local networks were more heavily exploited, they reached a critical mass of processing, achieving consciousness. Modern Geth retain this remarkable interconnectivity, constantly exchanging data with one another and networking to increase their cognitive abilities. To Geth, these mind-sharing abilities are as natural and unconscious as breathing is to most organics. Interesting. I always check to make sure if there's something added that I missed. Still haven't checked in with Garrus. Mess Sergeant Gardner? Yay! You're still alive.
You really are a hero.
Oh, thank you.
No sooner had the collectors damned us than you were pulling our sorry asses right back out of hell. Your ace is in my book, Shepard. Thank you.
Definitely my pleasure.
How can I help you, Commander?
Do you have everything you need?
Absolutely. Since you set up my kitchen with proper supplies, thanks again.
How do you feel about working for Cerberus?
Damn proud. Cerberus gets the job done. The Alliance and Council have got their heads bare. It'll take good old human ingenuity to crush these collectors.
I won't take any more of your time.
Back to work.
I'm so rude. Kind of disappointing. Disappointed no one's mentioning Tally.
For Sarah, now the collectors, remind me never to get on your bad side, Shepard. I almost feel sorry for the Reapers.
What can you tell me about the Normandy's armaments?
The weapons upgrades have gone in beautifully. This just might give us a chance against the Collectors.
Did more than that.
Have you got a minute?
Sure, just killing time anyway. Optimizing weapons charges. I'm still trying to figure out how to prepare for this mission. Humans don't deal with stress the way Turians do.
Thanks for the talk, Garrus. I'll see you later.
Sure thing.
Alright. I don't think we missed anybody. So, our next episode is going to be going to the Arrival DLC. Looking for the good doctor. Admiral Hackett asked Shepard to infiltrate a Batarian outpost and rescue Dr. Amanda Kenson. Kenson is a deep cover operative and scientist who claims to have proof of an imminent Reaper invasion. Right, to the Viper Nebula, which we actually have not... pretty sure we have not explored the Viper Nebula at all. To break Dr. Amanda Kenson out of prison. So that'll be next episode, or at least heading that way. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next time, and endure. Enduring? Grow strong.